I'm here with Eddie Terrazona and George from Ultimate Cigar Party. What do you think so far about the event?
Love it. Awesome afternoon. Great turnout, great people, great vendors, beautiful day. We got horses, we got slots, we got cigars, we got beer. What else can we ask for? It's perfect afternoon.
We have horse noises.
Nay.
There we go. Nay, the universal horse. So yeah, I mean, it's a fun event because I mean you've got 6 hours, you've got alcohol if that's your thing, you've got food, you've got sun, you've got cigars. We've got cigars. So just hanging out, having a good time with a bunch of people. Brought some new Lanceros that I just released, Connecticut Fuerte Lanceros. So we're giving those out. 307, still having a lot of fun with that one. Still probably right now still my best seller, Box Press Sumatra. At the show we put out the C276. I went down to Nicaragua for 2 months, so I kind of had something to prove and wanted, okay, I'm going to blend and keep blending and keep blending until I have what I want. Ended up with 5 different tobaccos in the filler, 2 Lajeros plus Ometepe. So, it's a cigar that I could not have blended a year and a half ago. We didn't have the knowledge, and I'm real, real happy with that. And so the Connecticut Fuerte has just been doing absolutely amazing. You know, it's a cigar that I tried to take a Connecticut and add a little bit more for the guys that wanted a little more out of Connecticut. But the audience I really got were all the guys that like said, I don't smoke Connecticuts anymore. They're too bland. I'd love to have a breakfast cigar, but it's just too bland. And so that ended up just kind of hitting the mark, which I'm real appreciative of. So I'm going to give the interview back to you because you're supposed to be doing this stuff and I don't get paid for this. So.
All right, well, I think you pretty much answered all my questions. The last thing I guess I had to say to you is, what's new in... It is. What's
number three.
I don't even know who he is. I really don't.
Good luck, number three.
But people ask if I gamble on these, and it's like I started a cigar company. How much more gambling do I need, really?
Well, that's true, right? But so anything new and exciting in World Nomad besides the new Lancero release?
I've got another blend I've been working on for about a year, and I'm real close. We had it, just laid it down for 90 days. I did it simultaneously as I did the 276, but I released the 276 because it was better portfolio-wise because I didn't have a full. So for me right now, only being in it for a couple years, I have all the pressure off because I feel like I have a complete portfolio. So like a year and a half ago, if I had just the mild or whatever, and everybody's like, oh, do you got something for medium or full? I'm like, no, I really don't, check out these guys type thing. So now I feel regardless of whatever your palate is, I've got something in your wheelhouse that is something for you to give a shot. So I'm real comfortable. So I have no pressure now to throw out a cigar. And not that I felt a ton of pressure before, but you want to get that portfolio at least mild, medium, full. And so, like I said, the other one that I've been working on, it's a medium stick. It's also Nicaraguan. I don't even think I've told anybody yet. So there you go. There's an exclusive. But I'm really, really happy with it. It's been laying down. Like I said, I started smoking them at like 40 days, and I'm really happy with that blend. But that'll probably be, sometime early next year.
All right. Excellent. Well, this is Fred Rui of Nomad Cigars. If you haven't tried them yet, you got to give them a shot. Like I said, S307, my absolute favorite from this line.
Thank you. Appreciate it.